Hello friends, welcome back to White Knight Corps. As you know, last section we have studied about placenta. Today's topic of discussion, I will speak about placental abnormalities. In point of view, it's an important topic for your examinations. So let's begin. If the placenta have any variations in terms of anatomical, physiological and abnormal implantation of the placenta, it refers to placental abnormalities. There are so many placental abnormalities, one by one we can see it. First we can see placenta sucinderata. So I have a placental image here for you. Look onto this placental image. Now we can see here there is a big placental mass, alright. Umbilical cord is attached at its center, that is also okay, but the problem we can see is an additional lobe here, and also this accessory lobe or this additional lobe is connected to the main bulk of placental mass by a leash of vessel. So this accessory lobe is the sucinderate lobe, and this condition is called as placenta sucinderata. And in some cases we cannot see these communicating leash of blood vessels, then it is called as placenta spuria. Now let's talk about second placental abnormality, placenta extracorialis. It is of two type, placenta marginata and circumvallate placenta. Look, this is a schematic representation of placenta, normal placenta, and is formed by maternal component and fetal component. This is the chorionic plate and this is the basal plate. And here in this figure, CP indicate chorionic plate and BP indicate basal plate. Normally, what happens is the placenta should be like this. The chorionic plate should be placed up till the basal plate so that they are equal in size. But what happened in this placenta extracorialis, that is in the circumvallate placenta and the placenta marginata, the chorionic plate is shorter. Please remember, the chorionic plate is shorter than the basal plate. So the membrane, chorion and amnion are folded, rolled back upon itself to form a ring centrally. So we can look what is happening in the circumvallate placenta. So look onto this picture. We can see a centrally depressed zone which is surrounded by a thickened white ring which is usually complete, and this ring is composed of a double fold of fetal membrane, the amnion and chorion. Then move on to the second type of placenta extracorialis, the placenta marginata. As in the circumvallate placenta, here also a ring is formed, which is a thin fibrous ring, and it is formed at the margin of the chorionic plate. So, let's see the third placental abnormality, the placenta membrane shape. In this case, the placenta will be excessively large and thin when comparing with the normal placenta. Here, what is happening means, normally the placenta is developing from the chorion, that is from the chorionic frontosome. But here along with this chorionic frontosome, it is developing from the chorionic leaf of the chorion also. That is, it is developing from both the chorionic frontosome and the chorionic leaf. Naturally, when it develops from the large area, the size of the placenta will also more. So the placenta will be covering majority of the developing fetus also. Next is bipartite placenta or placenta bilobate. If the placenta is divided into two portions, here you can see in this picture it is having nearly two equally sized discs. Okay, the peculiar feature of this abnormality is the placenta may develop as a separate and nearly equally sized disc. Then we can move on to another placental abnormality, placenta fenestrata. It is a rare condition in which the central portion of the discoid placenta is missing. So next we can see the abnormalities in the placental inversion. There are three types of placental inversions. They are placenta accreta, increta, and precreta. The first and the most common is placenta accreta. And this placenta accreta is an abnormality that occurs when the placenta grows too deeply into the uterine wall. And the second one, placenta increta. Here, the placenta attaches to the myometrium, which is the muscular middle layer of the uterus. And third one, placenta precreta. Here, the placenta will invade the perimetrium and may also extend to the wall of the urinary bladder or the rectum. Okay, and the last abnormality is placenta previa. Usually, the placenta is attached in the upper part of the uterus, but in this case, placenta will be attached in the lower portion of the uterus. That's all about placental abnormalities. I think it's clear for you, and we have seen different types of placental abnormalities today, and it has been asked for many times in the university examinations. So soon we will meet with umbilical cord abnormalities. If you like the video, please don't forget to like and support. Thank you.